We are about to start the session. So I, Professor Ghanshyam Rathore, welcome you all of you on this 1 week FTP on wearable devices and its fundamental.
Sir, please wait for a couple of minutes. It's already 11:13. Let us wait for a few more minutes and then we'll start.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes.
Ghanshyam sir, let me start now. I think already 11:18.
Yes, sir. So, good morning, all of you. I, Professor Ghanshyam Rathod, welcome you all on this 1 week FTB on wearable devices and its fundamental. We are going to start with the first session. Before starting the first session, I would like to give a brief introduction of today's speaker, our first experts, and I would like to introduce Dr. Bhargav Gorodia sir. Right now he is working as a head of the department of BVM engineering, head of the EC department of BVM engineering college. Dr. Bhargav Gorodia is a seasoned academician having more than 2 decades of experience. Presently Dr. Gorodia is professor and head of EC department. He is also a board member in BVM engineering college and other institutions. He is Vice President of Student Council and Executive Member of BVM Alumni Association. He is Chairman of Board of Studies in EC Department since 2015. He is having keen interest of developing sustainable, affordable, low-cost and robust solution for smart cities. His area of interest is towards machine learning, IoT and medical electronics. He was instrumental in fetching World Bank support MHRD TEQIP 2 grant of Rs. 10 crore at BVM. Dr. Gorodia was pioneer in promoting the entrepreneurship and has established BVM Incubation Center for promoting student startup activities. Institute has received a grant of 1.2 crore from SSIP under his leadership. He is having strong belief that engineering education is not within four walls of classroom, but is constant and continuous interaction with industries. He has set up Center of Excellence in the domain of IoT infrastructure in association with system level solution at BVM. Dr. Gorodia is the key member to develop various policies at BVM. He has also played a vital role in the major process of UGC autonomy, NBA, NIRF, FRC admission and many more. Dr. Gorodia has published more than 30 research articles in reputed international and national journals and conferences. He is working as editorial member and reviewer in various journals and conferences. So on this 1 week FTP, I would like to invite for the session number one, Dr. Bhargav Gorodia, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, your voice is muted. Okay.
Thank you, Professor Ghanshyam. At the outset, I would like to congratulate all the participants. As you all know, the title of FDP is Wearable Devices and its Fundamental. So today's session, I'm going to cover the concept to research level, and I will be also talking about some dedicated aspect of visually impaired. So let me present my screen. I hope the screen is visible to all.
Yes, sir. Now it's visible, sir.
Okay. So I would like to thank our management for providing us this opportunity to conduct this FDP on wearable devices and its fundamental. I would also like to thank AICT Atal to consider our application as one of the renowned application and permitting us to conduct this FDP. So being coordinator of this FDP, I would like to just brief about the various session at the end of this presentation. So as you all know that nowadays it has been very common and many of us are already using various gadgets which are wearable on our body. So let me quickly go through this is the outline of my presentation. I'll be introducing the fundamentals of wearable. I'll be also talking about brief history and background of it. I'll be talking about technological support for the wearable devices, the hardware, sensor and implementation of wearable, the design aspect and selection of material aspect I'll be touching upon, software support and mobile application development I'll be touching upon, Then I'll be discussing about variable for visually impaired, the statistics of visually impaired, existing and traditional solution for visually challenged individual, innovative solution for visually impaired, and I'll be also discussing about the scope of research and the way ahead. So although many of us are already knowing this, what is the definition of wearable devices? So it is stated like anything which can be worn on body is usually called as wearable. And then we add the electronics in it, then it becomes wearable electronics or electronic devices. So naturally, it is a relatively new term, we can say, but it has begun strongly to catch the hold in the technology community in the last decade. As you all know, that wearable electronic device can be defined as one of that intelligent and capable to take input, process that input, and provide the meaningful output. These are the nothing but the product which are implemented electronic technology and computing devices within their everyday functionality. Looking at the background of this, and historically, if we look at how it has been invented, then this was the man behind this wearable technology. So this was the person, Steve Mann, who has invented the first multimedia computer in the year 1981. And this was the first kind of wearable technology which has got a capability of capturing photo and video along with the text. So this was the person who has invented in the 1981. Although there were a few innovation took place before 1981, but this was the first kind of wearable innovation that took in the year 1981. Going to the little more background about it. So in the year 1961, Edward and Shannon created their own version of wearable technology, a computer small enough to fit into a shoe. So we have been talking about wearable technology for the shoe, but now I'm talking about the year 1961. In which these two gentlemen have created a small computer which can be fitted in a shoe, designed to help them cheat at game of roulette. The computer was timing device to predict where the ball would land. The another was wearable technology went into mainstream in 1975, where we can say first calculator wristwatch was released. So as you know that conventional wristwatch was available, but inbuilt calculator within the wristwatch was released in the year 1975. And it was worn by Sting on the cover of the Police wrap around your finger. So that was in the year 1975, we can say middle of 1718. Then very much familiar Walkman. We used to carry this Walkman and we used to enjoy the lovely music with the help of this Walkman. It was launched in the year 1979 and became our go-to music device throughout the 1980s, as well as within India. It was very popular even in late 90s. It is a revolutionary in case of music and wearable technology. The Walkman was so popular, it sold over 200 million units. So these are the some of the three wearable technology which were also invented and very popular in 70s, 80s and 90s. Talking more about the background, in the year 1994, Steve Mann, the person who has invented the first camera with photo, a Canadian researcher developed the wearable wireless webcam. Despite its bulk, it paved the way for the future IoT technologies. So wearable technology conferences and smart clothing expos began to see rise in the popularity throughout the decade. Then in the year 2003, at the University of the Washington, a study successfully determined that wearable GPS device could be used to track the pesticide level in the children. Then in the 2000s, wearable technology found its growth with the introduction of Bluetooth handset, and there are a lot many Fitbits which are available later on. In the year 2016 and 2013, the market was exploded with different wearable gadgets. Maybe it's wristwatch, Google Glass entered into the market, Apple Watch, and a lot many different gadgets had been entered. So this is the brief history. Since last 5-7 years, we all have been utilizing different one or other way of wearables in one or other way. So talking about the various technology requirement and various support requirement for wearables. So as you all know that first and foremost requirement is the hardware. There are a lot many sensors which are taking care of sensing different data and providing it to appropriate level. So sensors are naturally the backbone of this technology. Along with the sensor, there is a network and its protocol. In last decade, we have come across the Internet of Things, and the data are kept on the cloud. There are various tools available and the requirement of software. And finally, the mobile application which can support your wearable devices, right? So each and every gadget nowadays you look at, it is associated with its mobile application whereby you can track your data. So what are the different technologies that we have? So these are different various gadgets that are available, and they are operating in different range of technology. So we may talk about the wristband, we may talk about the smart ring, we may talk about this healthcare monitoring, we may talk about this smart wristwatch, GPS monitoring. Everything is having its own technology. So let us look at quickly that which are the body parts on which this wearable can be used. So right from head to toe, we can integrate or we can design or we can have this wearable. Start from glasses, watch, ring, bracelet, belt, pants and shirts, socks, shoes and fingers. So on the right hand side, as you can see that there are different wearables are shown, and naturally these wearables are smart wearables which are capable of developing and sensing the various parameters which are designed to sense, and they will be providing the data to the respective network. So there are three layers on which you can segregate this various body parts in which you can integrate or rather you can design these wearables. On the outer layer, you can see that close to the body. So we have various wearables which are nothing like clothes, shoes, emotion monitors, wearable cameras, activity trackers, smart watches, wearable controller movers, smartphones, accessories, sleep monitoring, AR, VR handsets, GPS tracker, wearable alarm system, and brain control headset. On the body, that is the middle circle, if you look at electronic glasses, sensor patches, electronic tattoos, insulin pumps, patches, 3D motion sensors, hearing aids, EEG, EMG devices, and the inner one that is inside the body, that is the dental hearing, artificial limbs, smart implants, smart pills, and bionic eyes. So there are a lot many innovation going on in all three dimensions. Particularly the inner one, that is the implant, they are the latest innovation and many companies are working on it. So as you can see that these different layers under which this wearable technology and devices can be developed and can be providing efficient data from the body. Talking about the various technology which helps us to transfer this data from one part to the other part. So within a body, there is always a wireless body area network that is associated or integrated within the device. So we call this as W-band, that is wireless body area network. So on the left hand side, as you can see, there is a W-band layer. Then there is in the middle layer, that is connectivity layer. And finally, on the right hand side, there is a service layer. So as you can see that there are various devices which are integrated with different protocols, which are able to connect the device with the connectivity layer. And through the connectivity layer, it is connected with the various service layer. It may be service layer to the server. It may be service layer which is connected with some emergency ambulance. It may be weather forecasting. It may be a doctor on a call. So there are various services that can be integrated on it. There are various protocols of the wireless or wire protocol can be integrated. Preferably because it is a wearable device, most of the protocols are wireless protocol, including ZigBee, Wi-Fi, and various other protocols which are supporting the faster communication. So the various technology which is used in WBAN, that is within the wireless body area network, you can always find that there are certain multiple devices are communicating with each other. Maybe you can say you have connected devices for monitoring EEG, EOG. You have connected device to monitor your SpO2, to blood pressure, EMG. So they are always communicating with each other, as well as they are communicating with the interband communication, that is with the outer world. And beyond that, that is they are connected with the other service agencies. So this is how you can say that the body area network is wirelessly communicating with the surrounding worlds through the internet. Let us quickly look at the various sensors, hardware and implementations. So first of all, I'll be talking about the sensors which are integrated, which are usually integrated with the wireless devices or the wearable devices. So there are different categories of sensors which are available, which can be integrated depending upon the application of the wearable devices. So accelerometer, proximity sensors, spectrometer, gyroscope, cameras, which is also associated with brightness, then microphone, compass, IR LED, IR photodiode, photoreflective sensors and temperature sensors, blood pressure sensor, electrodes, EEG, ECG, EMG and respirator sensors are there. GPS, RFID, ultrasound, ultraviolet, optical sensors are there. Then we have to monitor the ambience. We have humidity, pressure, weight, thermometer, magnetic coil kind of sensors are there. Fiber sensors, fiber optic sensors and textile sensors. So these are all different varieties of sensors. So we will be having a separate session in which this details of various sensors will be covered. But as you know that whenever you are integrating each one of these sensors, you need to understand the nitty-gritty of the sensors, how they take input, how they produce the output and how they are connected with the devices. Now, how these sensors are fetching the data, how these wearable devices will be fetching the data. So usually you can relate with this kind of sequence of phenomenon, that there is a physical phenomenon which our body parts at which these wearable devices are worn. So this will be sensed by the sensor. It is being conditioned through the signal conditional circuits. A sampling will be done. It will be converted to this analog values, because whatever body data are available, they are in the form of, mostly they are in the form of analog type. They are converted to its digital equivalent circuit, and then the converted data is given to microcontroller interface, and finally it is given to microcontroller where it is being processed, and based on the data is processed, the corresponding alerts or kind of alarm will be activated. Maybe it can be your footstep, it can be accounting of calorie, it can be any data which you are trying to sense. They are all available through this A2D converter and then finally available to controller, and controller will process it and then it is going to display in appropriate format. Maybe also transfer to various internet technology through various connectivity device. This is how a small working is explained with the help of a diagram. Whatever is the sensor is available, it will be taking input through this. There is a power requirement. We will be having a separate session to discuss about the power requirement for the wearable. So usually the inputs are sensed through the sensors and it will be processed inside, and it is connected with the memory as well as hard drive, as well as it is also going to give the output in the terms of camera, audio or monitor, right? There is always a concept of Internet of Thing. Whenever we talk about this wearable devices, this Internet of Thing is also going to play a vital role in the present as well as the futuristic wearable devices. So we can say that wearable devices are subset of Internet of Things because it is naturally integral part of wearable devices. So what is IoT? I'm just going to discuss a brief of IoT, that IoT is nothing but it is a migration of internet beyond the people. For example, the use of smartphone, watch, remotely unlocking your home, various home appliances, they are nothing but with the help of, they are controlled with the help of Internet of Things. So there are certain devices which are easily operable with the help of single click from your smartphone, smart devices. A smartwatch can be pre-programmed to turn up your heat on cold of mornings and turn down the heat at night. So these are all different things that you can program or pre-program in the watch, and then it can be automatically functioning to do the needful. So what are the different components within the IoT system? So there is a device, there is an internet connectivity and analytics associated with it. So central component of IoT, has naturally it is explained over here that there are some big things, there are some non-IP things, then there are small things, right? So this is how you can say that how this we call this as Internet of Things. So it may be having a small things, it may be having a big things, it may be having a things which are not having any internet protocol associated with it. So if the things are not having internet protocol associated with it, then you can do that with the help of IR or wire mechanism, and it is connected with the large and complex data model of the gateway, and then it is connected with the IoT server. Whereas the small and big things which has got this IP connectivity, they can be directly connected with this server, right? So how to build these wearable devices? So naturally you need to have a device with the sensors and various actions to be taken based on the sensor. Then you need to have the internet connectivity, and you need to have that internet connectivity with certain protocols associated with it. And finally, you need to have a server which is capable of doing analytics as well as it is connected with the various applications. So you require these three bare minimum things whenever you are trying to develop any wearable device. You need to require a device which is having a sensors, a group of sensors, and capable of processing in it. You need to require internet connectivity, which is backed with the various internet protocols. And finally, you require a server which is capable of doing some corrective measures or giving some alarm actions and analytics. How this sensors data is going to be processed? So just like I have discussed some common sensors. So common sensors including pressure, temperature, position, and humidity supports applications such as compasses, GPS, gyroscope to detect the movement. So movement detection, as you talk about the movement detection in your smartwatch, calculating the number of steps that you have done in a day or in an hour. So these are all basically included in the smart devices, and they are capable of identifying the movement, right? Sensors used in medical applications can be used to measure and monitor the blood flow, pulse, blood pressure, blood oxygen levels, muscle movement, and body fat and body weight. The most successful wearable are those that use algorithm to process raw sensor data into actionable, meaningful insight for the user, right? And finally, the communications, that is, wearable electronics must be able to communicate with the outside world. While the wireless connectivity through the short range radio or the other wireless protocol is popular, wire connectivity through the USB port is also commonly required. So what are the tasks being performed by the wearables? So taking advantage of constant human contact, people find that wearable electronics force a prolonged and consistent grid connection. So wearable tasks which are performed by this wearable is the data acquisition, live monitoring and feedback, computing power requirement, grid connection, and necessary measures through the communication. Talking about some of the implementations. So this is the one of the simplest example that is highlighted over here, how you can measure the heart rate through PPG. So this is how the PPG technology works. So you have these sensors. Here we have the sensor with the glass lid. You consider that this is a photo detector over here. There are two photo detector and there is a light source. When you put a finger on this device will give us your heart rate, right? So this is the blood vessel over here, which is highlighted in red. What usually happens, the light source will be emitting the lights and it will be reflected back to the photo detector through these veins, blood vessels. So every pulse create variation amount of the blood in the capillary. Light is projected on the capillary. light is reflected back depending upon the blood present on the blood vessel. Reflecting light is captured in the photodiode, and variation in the reflected light can be analyzed to measure the heart rate. So this is how the simple technology is utilized with the help of PPG. This is the PPG technology to monitor the or to measure the heart rate. This is one of the do-it-yourself kind of thing that you can identify that how it is being. Video is not playing over here, but this is one simple example. You will be able to see that the movement of the blood can be observed in it. This is how you can say that what you require to heart rate monitor. So signals can be analyzed to monitor the heart rate. You require alert sound and you require some data to be monitored. So a log is to be required to measure this heart rate. There are different devices that you can monitor sleep monitoring. So sleep monitoring is also one of the integral feature in most of the smartwatches that you have observed, right? So how it works, it is highlighted over here that heart rate is measured, and during the sleep, the heart rate is usually stable and constant, and therefore the device will be able to tell you that how many time you have spent in sleeping. This is another way of identifying the sleep tracking, and other assistive devices like morning routine is also giving some alarm that you need to take a milk, you need to take a key. So all these different options are available in different wearable devices. In fact, the night light control is also one of the thing which is available and popular, that automatically dimming the light, right? Automatically dimming the light and brightening the light. This is one of the latest technology which is usually you find in the wearable implants, that is bone conduction technology. In the bone conduction technology, there are signals directly sent to the brain through the bones, and then it is analyzed and processed. So we have different expert who is going to talk in detail about it. Then we can also have a smart cap which can be worn on the instead of this helmet. So you can just imagine that the different specification that can be highlighted on the right bottom side, you find out that there is a high performance microphone which is highlighted in a dot. On just above it, we have a polymer, lithium polymer battery. Then you have two bone conduction speaker which is connected over here. Then we have PCB and magnetic charger which is connected over here, and one touch on off switch is also kept over here. So this smart cap is capable of identifying, it is capable of identifying the different traffic and suggesting the speed of your vehicle which you are driving. So there are different people, different companies are working on this smart cap designing and manufacturing. As we all know that smart glass is also one of the common wearable devices, which is also comprises microphone, display and bone conduction speaker, as well as the AI feature is integrated in, that is artificial intelligence feature is integrated in it. Now let us talk about the design aspect and selection parameter of the wearables. Whenever you are trying to develop any wearable devices, one of the important aspect of any wearable is that how you are going to design this wearable. As in the beginning, I have stated that there are different body parts at which you can fit this wearable. So first of all, you need to understand that for which part you are going to design this wearable, right? So it is very important for us to understand that wearable to be designed very appropriately. So identify the best design. For example, there are various wearables are available for you can say that smart jewelries are available. So you need to identify the design appropriately, and then you need to develop a prototype, you need to validate that prototype, right? So check for the grip of the wearable. For example, nowadays it is very common to have a oximeter. So gripping the particular fingers in the oximeter is very, very important. If it is not able to grip it, then it is not going to function appropriately. There are different variables which are available, which can be kept in a pocket. So that is also to be designed. So therefore, the check for the efficient grip of the wearable device is very, very important. Then the ruggedness of the device is also a very important parameter. Developing, the next step is, once you are identifying the device for one particular part of the body, you need to develop a prototype. Once the prototype is developed, you need to test and verify it. Then, whenever you are talking about the wearable, there is an important aspect that to select the antennas for the wearable. Because whenever you are talking about the wireless communication, there is a small antenna which is integrated within it. So this FDP, we are not going to discuss much about the antenna, but in the upcoming FDP, where we are going to discuss the advanced level of this wearable device, in which we are going to discuss the antenna design for the wearables. But by and large, I'm just highlighting that there are different kind of antennas that can be integrated within the wearable device, and they are flexible antennas. This flexible antenna usually comprises two type of material. One is called conducting material and another one is called substrate material. And this conductive material for the antenna, they are mainly focusing on the two aspects. One is the thickness and conductivity parameters, whereas the substrate material is mainly focusing on the dielectric constant and loss tangent parameters. So there are different materials available for conductive and substrate. And based on your need, you can identify the antenna for the conduct, which comprises the various conducting material and substrate material. So there are long list of this material available. Depending upon this design and appropriateness of the application, you can select different materials for the designing of the antenna. Talking about the selection of various material, many a time we have observed that the device which you are wearing on your body might be creating itching at certain places, and therefore the selection of the material is very, very important for designing the wearable. So wearable material should ideally have following things. One is, it should be lightweight. It should not provide any burden to the part on which it is being worn. The polymer which is being used, its chemical property must be such that it should be comfort. It should provide comfort to the person who is wearing it. So it should be ultra comfortable and it should be soft to the touch. Then it should provide superior strain, ultraviolet, sweat and chemical resistance to the devices. It should also comprises the excellent suppliness of the easierness. It should also have premium quality feel, more robust and tear resistance, as well as it should have skin, best skin contact layer for the adhesive part. So whenever you are designing, the selection of the material is also playing a vital role. And this selection of material, there are a lot many materials available, which are available in different range, different cost is also one of the important factor depending upon the material which you are going to select for this. And finally, the moisture management. So the material which you are going to select, they are also supposed to have very good moisture management, right? And therefore, you can say that you want utmost comfort level whenever you are wearing on your body. And finally, the device which you are wearing, it should have foldable structure. Many a time you have seen that if you are one of the component, for example, talking about the smartwatch, then it should have foldable structure, should allow you to replace any one faulty component or the polymer or the belt part. Now talking about the software support and mobile application, that whenever we are talking about the wearable, there are a lot many different softwares available. Whenever any company is manufacturing any wearable device, it usually encompasses the device with the mobile application and related software. So I'll be talking about this in that perspective. You can also create your own mobile application with different software. So there are broadly many platform available. Those who are in computer and IT domain, they are very well aware that there are different softwares available. For example, the softwares which are the Android Studio, Eclipse are the two standard one. But nowadays, in the recent past, Flutter is the common application which is also popular for the new user who can develop their mobile application with the help of Flutter. So how it works? So this is one simple example that I have included in it, which is talking about the Flutter. The Flutter application is designed for the visually impaired people. So first and foremost requirement is creating a Flutter app, doing object detection using phone's camera to get information about the surrounding object. This is specifically I'm talking about for visually impaired people. And with the help of a simple Flutter application and integrating with the TensorFlow Lite and YOLO for the data send and to detect the object, creating boundary and boxes. Then finally, the converting the text to speech so that visually impaired people can listen to the audio instruction and move accordingly. So this is the simple block diagram that is designed for a blind person developing Android app, having a camera, and it will be identifying the obstacles with the help of captured image and identifying the data set, and finally it basically converts this obstacle into audio message so that it can give appropriate directions to the blind person. I'm not going to talk much about it, but there are different sources available where you can directly do it yourself for Flutter application, right? I'm also not going to speak much about YOLO because that is also one of the standard image processing application. I'm just giving you a brief introduction about Flutter. Is open source UIs and it is a software developed kit created by Google. It is used to develop Android applications, iOS applications for Linux, Mac, Windows, Google, and many other things, right? So you may do it yourself later on for going into the Flutter. Now I would like to talk more about the variables which are there for visually impaired, right? So if we talk about this section of our society, then the statistics says that within India we have 20% of visually impaired people, and current estimate of the blind in India that says that I have been mostly focusing on this 20% of the people, and based on that there are certain things that I would like to highlight, that what are the different technologies available and how the latest innovation is going to take place for these visually impaired people. So as we all know that there are various traditional solutions available for visually impaired people. This the most commonly learning thing is for visually impaired is Braille language. It is most traditional way to interpret the text. Sticks to avoid the obstacle, that is again one of the common thing that we have already knowing. But within the stick, lot many advancements are already happening. The sticks are available in folding, sticks are available with camera integrated, and it also has got audio assistance. So there are lot many design aspect is also integrated within this stick. Folding aspect is also integrated, camera integrated in it, and audio is also integrated within it. Now coming and talking about various innovative solution for visually impaired. So you see, this is the device. This is a device which is designed for specifically learning music. Those who are visually impaired as well as those who are not visually impaired, they can also utilize this device. So it is a handy device for learning music, and it start reading music. Whenever you rotate this device on this notations of the music, it will start reading music. On this side, you can see that there are speakers attached on it. There is a power, there is a battery backup, there is a power. Whenever you turn on the power and whenever you roll out on this music notation, it will start reading music. So device will assist to understand the music. Everyone who wants to learn the music can easily use this device. So music notations will be translated into audio, and finally it comprises a lens which is able to read these notations. It comprises speaker and it comprises various control option. So I suggest that because we are all academician, we can also try to develop such kind of prototype and we can utilize it for our own purpose. Now this is one of the most innovative solution which I observed. When somebody who is visually impaired and trying to read a textbook with a finger, then this device is very, very useful. So this is the device. As you can see, that this is a device prototype which I am just highlighting over here. And this device prototype is designed in such a way that it can be worn on a finger, and whenever you are trying to roll your finger, it will translate in real time. It will translate in real time whatever the text is written, it will translate into audio, right? So what it comprises, it is called a finger reader. It is very, very versatile and easy to fit in the finger. It reads the written text. Now question comes in your mind. For example, there are different text format available and different text size, font size are available. So specifically this device is designed in such a way that it is going to read a specific font type as well as specific font size. So we can also develop this kind of device for our own purpose. This device is designed for specific purpose and it is designed for specific font size and specific font type. So it is designed for 12 point fonts, and this device can easily read alouds in real time. The size of the font is 12 point. Now question comes in your mind. By chance, because this is being used by the visually impaired, by chance if the device is being used by visually impaired and the movement of finger is not in the straight line, then there is a vibration sensor is also attached with it. So deviation offline will be notified through the vibration in the finger. That means that it indicates that you are not moving your finger in a straight line. So that is also included in it. So this prototype is developed by Media Labs, and this can also be used to teach the student, right? Maybe I can say that those who are learning in our pre-primary section, this device can also be given to those students, whether they are visually impaired or not, but this can really be a very good device for our pre-primary students, and teachers can provide this kind of device to the student so they can understand the meaning of each and every text or word written. It is OCR based text reader, right? So there are many such things are available. You can also apply and you can also create your own device having this kind of mechanism. You can try and develop your own device having this kind of feature. Coming to various few more innovative solution. So these are the various innovative solutions which I have took from various research articles. As you can see that this is a gadget which is to be worn within the body of the visually impaired person, and this can guide to the person that whether the obstacle is available in front, in left or right direction, and it provides the effective audio assistance that you can move straight, left or right. So this is a contactless, intuitive, hands-free and discrete wearable device that allows visually impaired user to detect low and high hanging obstacle as well as physical boundaries in their immediate environment. The solution allows for safe local navigation in both confined as well as open space by enabling the user to distinguish free space from the obstacles. The device comprises of two parts, the sensor belt and a haptic strap. The sensor belt is an array of the time of flight distance sensors worn around the front of a user's waist, and the pulses of infrared light provide reliable and accurate measurement of the distance between the user and surrounding obstacles or surfaces. So this device is very, very useful. This is the reference from which I took this. The interested individual can refer this and go into the depth of it. I'll be showing this video before I wind up my presentation. It is not available in this presentation. This is one of the innovative ecosystem that we can prepare for the visually impaired. So usually we have observed that there are various varieties of solutions available for visually impaired, but there needs to be a robust ecosystem should be available for visually impaired. So it may be in terms of smart smooth, it may be in terms of smart glass, it may be in terms of smart wearables, textiles, it may be in terms of wristwatch, or maybe you can also have a creativity in terms of electronic tabla. So this is one project on which we are working, and we are trying to develop this ecosystem for visually impaired. So this is the most innovative solution which is developed recently by the company. I'm not going to name it. I'll be showing the video before I wind up my presentation. So this is a smart shoes, we can say. This smart shoes comprises a device which is AI control device. It has got inbuilt artificial intelligence module in it, and it is going to track everything. Because it is kept on a shoes, all the necessary precautions are integrated in it. It is a waterproof device. And as you can see, that batteries are integrated at the back side of it. And there are a lot many other devices, innovative devices are available for visually impaired people, like talking thermometer. We have not heard of it because we have not thought of it. But there are devices which are available specifically for visually impaired. That is talking thermometer, talking calculator, talking pulse oximeter. And we also have braille reading and writing devices. We also have laptop for visually impaired. So these are all different devices which are available, and the lot many researches are happening in the domain of such devices which can be utilized by visually impaired. Now coming and talking about this research scope for the wearable devices. So I have been talking about this wearable devices. So there is a huge scope of devices to be charged wirelessly, whether it is wearable or not. But wireless charging is one of the important area of research where people are paying attention. Then wearable glasses for doctor's companion, for example, there are different surgeries are going on. And during that surgeries, doctor needs to pay attention to the various devices to identify the different levels of the patient. So there are research going on where wearable glasses can be designed, and the doctors can monitor all the parameters through that glasses. So doctors need not to move their eyes from the patients to other devices. Wearable with AI capabilities is also one of the important area of research. Smart textile and smart jewelry. We do have a dedicated session on smart textile, e-textiles, where you will be able to learn a lot many things. So I'm just going to discuss, these are some of the smart textiles which you can see that various companies are manufacturing smart textiles. So a lot many extensive research are going on in this sector, particularly Samsung and various other big players are working on it. As you can see that various places there are different sensors and monitoring parts are integrated in this. So this is a smart blood oxygen level ring. This is a smart t-shirt, you can say, in which all the different sensors are integrated in it. which is going to identify your blood pressure, skin temperature, activity level, breathing rate, as well as heart rate and electrical activities are being monitored through this kind of devices or this kind of textiles. Talking about smart clothing, already we do have various companies those who are manufacturing this smart socks. So the smart sock can detect that developing the foot ulcers. Then the company called Nadi X Smart Pants developed by, so it is basically yoga pants, we can say, that vibrates to improve form during yoga exercise. Then this is a swimsuit which is developed by Naviono company, which is also identifying the various important parameter of the body. This is one another look for smart jacket and smart clothing. Talking about various implants which are available. So the implants which are available are mainly focusing and working in the direction where particularly this implants are working in the body inside, and they are identifying various parameter of the skin and body. So in near future, you may have smart tattoos may also become available for a patient who wants to do some easy way of ensuring that doing something very easy. So whenever we talk about this smart implants, there are smart pills are also available. And these smart pills will be able to monitor different parameters within the body. When you are taking this smart pill, it is going to measure different important parameters of some of the organs. So these are the different steps that is going to be taken by that smart sensor network. So tiny silicon sensor, the size of a grain of salt is attached to this regular pills. The patient swallow the pills with the sensors, which is activated by the gastric juices in the stomach. The sensors generates a signal determining the identity of medicine and the time of the ingestion of the pill. A banded like disposable patch attached to the patient's skin record the data from the sensors along with the heart rate, activity and other body metrics. Data is sent to the Bluetooth enabled device like a phone or a computer, where it becomes accessible by the caregivers or clinicians. The system also allows user to set up alarms to remind them to take medicine or to go to off when they are inactive for a certain time. So the research is going on and lot many things are happening in this domain. We all know various head mounted displays. I'm not going to talk much about it, but this head mounted display is also one of the very important wearable devices. There are three types of the things that you can go for. That is virtual reality, augmented reality and mixed reality, which comprises virtual and augmented reality both. So what is way ahead? When we talk about these wearable devices, what is the way ahead for these wearable devices? So many of you must have not heard, but the day is not far when the corporates will be going for wearable in insurance. So what is the meaning of wearable in insurance? So thanks to the growing popularity of the wearable devices, insurers can now reduce the rising cost per patient by using them as a means of increasing the customer lifetime value. So how does it work? So by equipping the customer with the wearable technologies, insurers can incentivize the behavior to reduce the hospital admissions or eliminate the unhealthy lifestyle choice and poorly manage the personal health. So this is going to become it may happen that because of this pandemic and because of the present time, it may happen that various corporate may try to go for wearable in insurance, that company may ask the employee to compulsory go for this kind of wearable insurance, where they will be monitoring the health of individuals, and therefore they are saving the lives of individual as well as the cost of the hospital admissions. So most people who use such devices agree that wearables help them to become more aware of their health and inspire them to improve their diet and exercise regime. In this future, more insurance company will look into the possibility of making wearable technology one of their key strategies. So when we talk about way ahead, I already stated that fitness tracking for employees, the rise of smartwatches, smart clothing are the important aspect. So before I go to other things, I would like to show you a small video.
He is one of the greatest football players in the world. They are 12 exceptional visually impaired individuals of different ages and diverse backgrounds. This year, they met.
Sir, can you restart the video again, sir?
A magical moment that changed.
Sir, start the video from beginning, sir.
Okay.
He is one of the greatest football players in the world. They are 12 exceptional visually impaired individuals of different ages and diverse backgrounds. This year, they met. A magical moment that changed their lives forever and left Messi speechless as he presented them with the revolutionary Orcam Maya.
Leo Messi.
Increíble lo que puede llegar a ser este aparatito.
The ability to recognize faces, to read and understand any kind of text, so they simply ask to read only what interests them.
Read the headline.
Another brilliant performance.
Wow.
Identifying money notes. Orientation helps you understand what's in front of you.
What's in front of me?
A copy is in front of you.
Identifying products and barcodes.
Al punto del sal.
This is a magnificent piece of technology.
Activated by voice command, Orcam MyEye is the most advanced wearable assistive technology, helping to improve the lives of visually impaired people.
Orcam MyEye, esto es increíble, esto es magia.
Orcam MyEye, for blind and visually impaired people. Share this video to help us spread the word.
It's going to be life-changing for myself and a lot of my friends.
So this is one kind of video. As you can see that the things are growing very fast. I'll be also showing one more video, which is going to show you how the smart shoes is going to. Unfortunately, audio is not working in this video, but have a look at this. The smart shoes is designed by Innovec company. He is visually impaired and he is doing it alone. He is crossing the road with the help of the audio assistance from the shoes. So it has got obstacle detection system, which is backed with the artificial intelligence. It can detect the obstacle up to 4 meters range. As I said, it is a waterproof device. And Bluetooth is linked with the smartphone. So this is how it can be integrated in the shoes. So I just paused that video over here. Yeah, so this is what I wanted to show with you. I think now the forum is open for the question answer, if any.
Sir, there was a question during your session from Mr. Mohit Chaudhary.
Yes.
And the question was about something that is it possible to develop such application and run on any Android phone, or we need a phone with specific feature. So Mohit sir, can you please write regarding which application you were discussing? Even sir, you can see the same question in the chat section.
Just a minute, hold on.
It was at 11:55. The question was there. I have already circulated the attendance sheet for the participants in the chat section. And yes, participant, please share your question in question and answer section.
Okay, so far as I understand the question, that is it possible to develop such application and run on any Android phone? Yes, the application, I think you are talking about the application that you want to develop for any of the device. So usually the mobile application development, yes, you can develop the application with the help of different platform, either Android Studio or Eclipse or with the help of Flutter. And yes, of course, you can operate that application with the Android phone. There are different protocols to be observed for developing iOS application, but usually most of the companies, those who are developing this wearable, they develop the application for Android as well as for iOS. So yes, of course, one can develop the application for the appropriate wearable that you are designing. And naturally, it can be developed for either Android as well as for the iOS.
Okay, yeah, participant, yeah. If you have any other question, please write the question in the chat section. We are waiting for the question, and yes, attendance sheet is already shared.
Yes, any more question? Yeah, we have one more question. Somebody has raised the hand.
So I'm just making you your audio enabled, so you can ask the question directly. Mohana Thadi. Yeah, there are a few questions in chat section also, sir.
Yes, I could read that. What about the reliability of data transmitted by sensors? Yes, so see, data transmitted by sensors, usually the sensors which are integrated in the variable are very robust and they are quite accurate. So the data which is being sensed by the device and then later on it is processed by the devices, they are usually quite accurate. Once we are talking about the data is transmitted to the cloud and other aspect like then there are different communication protocol, as I said in the beginning, that the protocol which you have internet connectivity is in most of the case internet connectivity is one of the very important aspect. So whenever you are integrating this with the internet connection, then you need to identify how you want to communicate with the server, right, or the cloud. So I think the data which is transmitted, they are quite reliable. I'm not able to hear the audio clearly.
Sir, am I audible now?
Yes, yes, yes.
Sir, this is Gauri from Vishakhapatnam. Sir, you have seen in your you have shown in your presentation about the smart pills, sir. Pills, swallow the pills.
Right.
So is it digestible, sir?
Yes, yes. The pills which are.
So some sensor is kept inside that.
Yes,
yes sir. Some yes. sensor is kept inside that pill. You have said.
Yes, sir.
If it is inside, if you swallow that pill, what is doing inside, sir? It senses some data. After that,
see, therefore I mention all the six steps. There are the pills available within the pills.
Yes,
within the pills, let me just present that thing again, if you wish. But there are research is going on, and various companies are already developing such pills which can be taken by the patient who is supposed to be monitored on a regular basis. Particularly, some organs are not working properly, and to check the progress of that organ, such kind of pills are usually to be taken by the patient. So let me just highlight those points so that you can easily understand.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
So I think you are talking about you are talking about this. So this is how the different things are. Once the pills are swallowed, basically the sensors is separated from it, and once the sensor is separated from it, it sensors generates a signal which is determining the identity of the medicine and the time of the ingestion of the pill. So usually, as it is mentioned, that it is basically a banded like disposable patch which is available, and it is going to take care about the recording patient skin as well as different data related to patient, for example heart rate and activity of other body matrices. So this is the strap which is separated, and then it is going to take care about, and this is having a Bluetooth connection with your smartphone or smart devices. So this Bluetooth connection will be able to monitor that what are the different parameters that you want to monitor for your inner parts, right? So that's how this lot many research are going on, but there are some companies those who are developing this. So if you look at these sensors, this is how this the magnified view of this sensor. This is the magnified view of these sensors. You can say the device has a tiny coating of the copper and magnesium, two minerals needed in our daily diet. So this is how this you can go and you can do the research on this. You will find that there are various different materials which are coated on the pills, which are needed for the body. So naturally they are not going to harm the body, because whenever you are talking about this pill, lot many precautions needs to be taken, whether it is harmful or not. If it is harmful, naturally the kind of innovation is not going to work. So I have also highlighted the source over here. You can refer this and you can go in the depth of this topic.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, any other query? So I could read some of the messages like, sir, tell about latency of the wearable device when it is sending biomedical related data to a server. See, yes, Srividya, whenever you talk about latency, usually if you are talking about wearable medical, usually the data latency, you can even think of 2 to 5 minutes or maybe 2 minutes. But when you talk about 2 minutes latency, 2 minutes is good enough time for any server to get the data, provided the internet connectivity is there. See, all depends on the internet connectivity. When we talk about this wearable devices, they are capable of providing the data depending upon the speed of the controller that you have integrated in it. But usually within a microsecond or millisecond, the data can be available to the server, provided the internet connectivity is there. So when we talk about this latency, latency is not going to play a vital role, because 1 or 2 minutes is tolerable whenever you are talking or interested in getting data from the wearable device. 1 or 2 minutes is naturally desirable. But when you talk about, let's say, a smartwatch, when you talk about smartwatch, so smartwatch, when you are interested in counting the number of steps that you have walked, naturally the sensor is going to do that task in a real time. But when you are trying to send the same data to the cloud, then it depends on the internet connectivity and the speed. Otherwise, the sensors are going to sense the data in real time. Sensors are going to sense the data in a real time. I hope I am answering the question. Mohit Chaudhary, sir, what you have written is there any camera that can capture the digital picture, and is there any interface available through which the capture image can be transferred to the brain through neuro signals so that a person may get the idea of what he or she is seeing? Presently, I am not aware about this kind of sensor, but again, we have scheduled one session wherein we have kept it for this kind of signal monitoring. We have two experts who is going to talk about the data analysis as well as on health monitoring. They will be able to answer your query in detail. But I'm not much aware about any such sensor who can capture the images. But I can say that example which I've just narrated with the smart helmet or smart cap, you can integrate a camera at the top of your head. It can do the same thing what you are seeing. Ultimately, if your objective is to capture the image what you are seeing, then you can develop that kind of smart cap or helmet in which you can integrate that camera. It will serve the purpose. Yes, we have few more raise hand. If moderator can allow them to speak.
Yes, sir, I am just allowing them. So already it is allowed. Mic is already given, permission given is already.
Okay. So please ask your question, BYK Hita.
Hello.
So the question, initially the slide said the question asked from the same person. I think the query was done.
Okay.
Sir, we are getting few questions in chat section. And participant, you can share the question in the attendance sheet also. It is there in the feedback part. You can write your question in that also.
Sasikala, you are asking, whatever you are saying, I will agree while walking. If water is there, then it will affect the device. Is it correct? See, yes, if I could identify that you are talking about the smart shoes, which I have just shown to you. So yes, of course, the device which are water resistance. So this water resistance capability are to be integrated in the device which is manufactured. So naturally, whenever even you must have heard that there are smartphones which are available which are water resistance. So there are specific kind of displays which are available, which provides this capability, IPS 267 kind of thing. If I'm not wrong, then there are specific kind of material in which the device are manufactured, which provides the water resistance. So naturally, they will be able to work faithfully even when the device is getting wet. Yes, Priyanka Singh, any query?
Yes, sir. I have one query that after implantation, we need to make a rapid thermal annealing.
Sorry, rapid?
Thermal annealing, sir.
I'm sorry to say, but I'm not the one who has penetrated much in this, but I'm just showing that these are the areas in which the research is happening and going on.
Okay, sir. And sir, what are the more resources that we can get from these topics?
We can access. Yes. So we have various sessions that we have arranged. If you look at the schedule, we have expert who is going to, if you are interested in wearable textile technology, the there are a lot many things which I already highlighted. Many companies are working, including Samsung. Those who are working aggressively to develop this different kind of textiles and clothing sensors. If you are interested, you can also look at the, it depends on your area of interest, but selection of material, there are various different polymers which are available where you can identify the different characteristics. Along with that, there are a lot many research, as I said, happening in wearable antennas, because the antennas are to be integrated in the wearable devices. And whenever you are integrating this antenna, there are two materials to be used, as I said. And depending upon the cost analysis and the affordability aspect, one can choose that two material. So there are different materials for antennas are available, and substrate materials are also available. So what I suggest is there are many things that can be done, particularly in medical wearable devices. There are a lot many areas. One and important thing is, like I have just stated, that the finger reader, then there are various different devices which can make your blood movement very faster. So all this kind of prototype needs to be developed, and it needs to be validated. And so far as this, what I suggest, jewelry part, smart jewelry, this is also one of the upcoming. But for that, we may not be in the position to develop this tiny sensors, because there are a lot many giants available, those who are developing sensors. We can do one thing. We can try to integrate those sensors in the smaller area. But whenever we talk about the integration, we need to look for the resource support, that is power requirement and the integration module of how communication is going to be established. So we have two sessions for power. One is for linear devices power management, and another one is the generic optimization of the power within the device. So power management is also one of the challenges when we talk about the variables. So our next session, that is our keynote session. So our keynote speaker, who is going to talk about the challenges and prospects for the variable devices. So I suggest that you just identify which area of variable you want to work, and then you can start developing your, first of all, identify the sensors requirement, identify the power requirement, and then you look at the communication protocol you want to integrate, and then you can develop the mobile application. Mobile application, see, if you are not comfortable with the mobile application can be also developed by taking help of some professionals.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
So I believe that we do not have any more question.
Yes, sir. General queries are there.
Yeah.
So I'm just stopping the recording and.
No, you can carry on. No issue, sir. You can ask question. If there is any other more query, you let me.
There's a question like, is it how? What is the attendance criteria and all? So that is a general. Yeah. One question is that. Regarding textile, smart textile, and Seval Kumar sir is asking for some research-oriented laboratory available regarding smart textile and all. So those are common. Those are the questions we are getting.
Okay, fine. So we will be having a session on Friday morning, and Mr. Prashant Verma is going to talk about the e-textile and smart clothing. So we will have more insight about smart clothing and smart textile in that session. He will be also highlighting the various resources for working for the various smart textile mechanism. In fact, we have tried to contact a few individuals, those who are working abroad and those who are working on smart textile, but they are not in position to set their timings with Indian timing. But we will provide you the appropriate information once we finish this FDP, right?
So, sir, I think we are about to end the session.
Okay, fine.
And thank you very much, all the participants. Now, the next session will be at 2 p.m. Till then, the lunch break will be there. And that session is a keynote session from Engineer Nilesh Ranpura, sir, and the topic will be variable devices, prospects, and challenges. So I request all the participants to join nearby 1:55, and till then the link will be disabled. You will be in lobby if you are going to join before that. So I request to join on a time, and you will get the message in WhatsApp whenever the session is going to start. So thank you for attending, and thank you for being with us, and we'll see you in the next session. Thank you all.
Thank you for interactive sessions. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Bhargo, sir.